taken from the question papers of the year 2017 and 2018 also. These questions have appeared in SBIPO also, that is bank exams also, and in SSC CGL exam also. We'll start them one by one. What is the value of 12 by square root of 5 plus square root of 3, 18 by square root of 5 minus square root of 3? The four options are there. We have nothing, no option except to simplify this. So we'll proceed like this. Write it as 12 by square root of 5 plus square root of 3 and take 6 out. This 12 we take 6 out, 2 and 18 will become 3 here. And after this we can take the LCM of these two expressions, because we know that it is a plus b into a minus b. After taking the LCM, we will have 6 is already out. And you take this 2 square root of 5 minus 2 square root of 3 and this becomes this. And then a square minus b square. And then we can simplify it to finally obtain 3 5 square root of 5 plus square root of 3 as the answer. So this is how we could have done it. The next question is, S, T and U can complete a work in 40, 48 and 60 days respectively. They received ₹10,800 to complete the work and they began the work together. So all of them started together, but T left after 2 days before completion and U left 5 days before the completion. S has completed the remaining work alone. What is the share of S from the total amount, that is 10,800? So this is a fairly complicated question, but we need to be very smart in this. Let's see, these are the options. Such questions, we take the LCM of the time they take to complete the work. This LCM is 240. So the efficiencies are 240 by 40, LCM divided by the number of days each takes. The efficiencies come as 654. So now, had all of them worked together, that is no absenteeism, then share of S would have been in proportional to his efficiency. 6 by 6 plus 5 plus 4 into the total amount. This would have been the share. This means the answer would be at least this much. And when I see only this one is ruled out, this is possible, this is possible and this is possible. So we need to work more. Okay, proceed further. Now we'll take out how much of the excess work has been done by S. So for that we'll calculate the additional amount he can get. Work not done by T and U will obviously be the work done in excess by S. So what is the work not done by T? T left 2 days before the completion. So he didn't do 2 days work. So he didn't do this much work, 2 by 48. And U left 5 days before, he didn't do 5 by 60. Because he takes 60 days to complete the whole work, so in 5 days he must have done this much work. The total amount of work, 1/8, has been done in excess by S. This means he should be given 1 by 8th of this amount more, which is 540. So S gets total 4860, which is the right answer in this case. So see the method I followed. Let me move to the next question. A farmer's land is in the shape of a trapezium. A trapezium is something like this, two parallel sides and two non-parallel sides, which has its parallel sides measuring 2.56 and 3.44 yards. And the distance between the parallel sides, this distance is given as 1.44 yard. The cost of plowing the field is Rs. 1800 per square yard. What will in rupees have to be spent in order to plow the entire field? The options are these. This is a simple question. What we have to do is we have to find out the area of the field and then multiply it by the rate. That will give us the final answer. The area of a trapezium is given as the average of the two parallel sides into the distance between them. Two parallel sides added divided by 2 multiplied by the distance between them. So this is the area that you get, 3 into 1.44. I haven't multiplied it. Rather, the cost is 3 into 1.44 into 1800. So now here I'll have to add some smartness. I won't calculate it. I'll try to see which of these options is possible. Last digit should be 3 into 4 into 8. Because this 0.44 will combine with 00 to remove it. So last digit should be 3 into 4 into 8, which is 6. And therefore, this is the only possible candidate, which is the correct answer. Take note of the smartness that I use in this. The question next is, if after giving a discount of 18%, a book is sold for ₹15.99, the discount is this much, then what will be the marked price? So these are the four options. This is a case of let the marked price be 100. Then the sale price is going to be 82. 100 minus 18. Unitary method. If sale price is 82, then marked price was 100. If sale price is given as 1599, then the marked price would be this much. And here also, I'll not divide. I'll instead try to multiply 82 by this, 82 by this, 82 by this, 82 by this. And I see that when we multiply 82 by 1950, we will get an answer closer to 1599. So reverse engineering can be done. So if I multiplied 82 to 1800, it would have given me 6 at the last position, 8 to 6. So this is not possible. Similarly, this is not possible. And 5 to 10, and then 9 to 18, 19. So this gives me 9, and which will tally with this one. Similarly, this is absolutely not possible. So let us move to the next question. I am not calculating any of my calculations. A man has 3 sons, 2 daughters and a wife. They divided a sum of ₹19,000 among themselves such that each daughter got 1.5 times the amount received by each son. And his wife received 600 less than each son. What is the total amount in rupees received by their 3 sons together? So this is a bit tricky, but anyhow, these are the options. So let one son get X. Wife has been given in relation to one son, daughters also in relation to son. So one son gets X. So daughters get 1.5x plus 1.5x. And wife got X minus 600, sons would have got 3x. This total should be 19,000. Simplify it, X will be 2800. We are required to find out 3x. So 3x equal to 3 into 2800 equal to 8400 is the correct answer. So this was a simple equation that had to be set up. The average of 3 consecutive even numbers is EA. So even numbers like 2, 4, 6 and all. If next 5 even numbers are added, then what is the average of the 8 numbers? So 3 are already there. Their average is given as capital A. If next 5 are added, then what is the average? Now don't go into all the detailed mathematics. Let us start this way. Take the 3 numbers as minus 2, 0, 2 so that A is 0. You add them, they add to 0 and therefore the average is 0. This will simplify. Now what we have to do is take the average of the, take the sum of the next 5, which is 40, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 40. Now 40 plus these 3, average of all 8 is 40 plus these 3, these are already adding to 0. Divided by 8, there are 8 numbers, 5 these, 3 those, and therefore the average of all 8 will be 5. And now we can check out that 0 plus 5 will be identical to A plus 5, and therefore this is the correct answer. While selling an article for ₹18,450, a person suffered a loss of 50%. At what price he should have sold the article to earn a profit of 50%? These are the four options. So how do we solve? Practically speaking, a loss of 50% means the cost price would have been double this much. Then only he would have lost half. And for a profit of 50%, his sale should have been 1.5 times the cost price. Then only he would have earned 50% of the cost price. So if this is so, then the sale should have been 1.5 times 2 times 18, 14, 450. This is the cost price. 1.5 times cost price, 1.5, this is the cost price. So this is 3 into this. And now you can see that the second digit should be, the last digit should be 0, but the second should be 5, 3, 5, 15. And out of these only, this one is the correct answer. No calculations needed. So let us move to the next question. If you are finding these difficult the way I am solving them, then please go through this pen drive course. I have given very simple explanations from the basic concepts. Right now it's not possible for me to go for that. I am simply solving it because every student will be looking for quick answers. So here it is. The present population of a town is 26010. It increases annually at the rate of 2%. What was the population of town 2 years ago? When we have something to do with population, we are to use the formula for compound interest. Okay, these are the four options. Compound interest is given by P into 1 plus R by 100 raised to the power N. We are all aware of this. So, amount is given to us 26010. We are asked the principal amount 2 years ago. So, P into 1 plus rate is 2% raised to the power 2. So, P should be 26, you have taken this to the other side, 26010. So, this was 1 by 50. So, 50 into 50 by 51 into 51. And this is 2601, we already remember. And therefore, things cancel out. And after cancellation, 25,000 is the correct answer. A train of length 100 meter crosses another train of length 150 meters. This is 100 meter length train. And this is 150 meter train. This is coming this side and this is going this side. In the opposite direction, they cross each other in 9 seconds. So they must have touched at this point and time was counted from here. If speed of train having length 150 meter is 40 kilometers per hour, then what is the speed of the other train? Okay. The trains have together collapsed 100 plus 150 meters in 9 seconds. This is what is given to us. This means the relative speed, the total speed, because they are in the opposite direction, their relative speed will be the total sum of the speeds, should be equal to the distance covered 250 divided by the time of 9 seconds, and this is meters per second to kilometers per hour. So the total speed of both the trains should be 100 kph, and therefore the speed of the other train should be 100 minus 40. This one is 40 given to us, and therefore the balance is 60 kph, and this is the correct answer. The next question is, what is the difference of the cube and square of the common root of this equation and this equation? These equations must be having some common root and we have to find out the difference of the cube and square of that. And these are the options. Okay. Write the equations in factored form. Orally we can factor them out. X square minus 8x plus 15 is x minus 5 into x minus 3. The other equation is factored as y minus 5 into y plus 7. We observe that 5 is the common root. And what is to be found out? 5 cube minus 5 square. Take 5 square common. 5 minus 1, 4 into 25, 100. 100 is the correct answer. If x minus 1 by 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square is 0, then what is y plus x and what is y minus x? The ratio is required to be found out. The sum of the squares has been given equal to 0. And these are the four options. LHS can never be negative. This is the square of a positive quantity. Square of a positive quantity. The left hand side can never be negative. left hand side can't be negative, it can be 0 or positive. But it will be 0 if each term is 0. So we should have x equal to 1 by 3 and y equal to 1 by 4. The square of 2 terms is 0 only if each of the terms is 0. So x is 1 by 3 and y is 4. And now we have to just substitute and we will get 13 by 11 as the correct answer. These questions are real questions based on memory that have been asked in the previous year. So you can see that these look difficult on face, but they are very easy. Now he says, what is the difference of the factors of the expression x square plus 1 by x square minus 6? So we have to find the difference of the factors. So we have to obviously factorize it and rewrite as x square minus 2x square into 1 plus x 1 by x square plus 1 by x whole square minus 4. So this is smart rewriting. X square, this x square comes, this 1 by x square, this remains. Out of 6 we have taken 2 here and my eye is on the formula a square minus 2ab plus b square, and from here we can now see that it is x minus 1 by x whole square minus 2 square. This one is 2 square. So this is x square minus y square, and now we can factorize it as x minus 1 by x minus 2 into x minus 1 by x plus 2. So these are the two factors. We have to find the difference. So difference is obviously this is same, cuts out 2 plus 2, 4. And therefore 4 is the correct answer. So this is how we work out. Now this is a question from the geometry part. If D and E are points on the sides AB and AC respectively of a triangle ABC such that DE is parallel to BC, AD is X, DB is this, A is this, EC is this, then what is the value of X in centimeter? Best thing is to draw a diagram. This is diagram. This diagram was not given in the paper, but we have drawn it. So ABC is a triangle and DE is parallel to BC. This is X and this is so. So simple, by the triangle proportionality theorem, the ratio of this to this should be equal to the ratio of this to this here, like here. Transposing and solving, so just nothing else. So you will get X equal to 9 by 2 equal to 4.5. So if you want, you can just check it out. So x square minus 2x, and this is x square minus 9. This x square already cancels out, and therefore x is 9 by 2 equal to 4.5, which is the right answer. Now he says, if medians of a triangle have lengths 18, 24 and 30 centimeter, medians have been given. This is a triangle. This is median that divides into two parts, equal parts. The length of the medians has been given to us, and what is the area of the triangle? There is a simple formula for the area of triangle in terms of the lengths of the medians. You can remember the formula is 4 by 3 square root of s into s minus a, s minus b to s minus c, where a, b, c are the lengths of the medians and s is the a plus b plus c, the average of the three medians. So we have s is equal to 36. 4 by 3 into square root of 36, 36 minus 18, 36 minus 24, which you can see this will be 36, this will be 18, this will be 12, this will be 6, and you can just find out this is 6 into 3, rather 9 into 2, 3 into 4, 3 into 2. Taking common things, you will see that it comes to 4 by 3 into 216, which is 288. 288 is the correct answer. This is a formula based question. This formula you should remember. Two smaller circles touch a large circle internally and pass through the center O of the large circle. So diagram can be like this. This is the center. They are touching internally and something like this. If the diameter of the bigger circle is 28, then what is the area of the bigger circle which is not enclosed by the two smaller? That is, we have to find out this portion. So simple, take out the area of the bigger circle, subtract the areas of these two. So radius of the larger circle is 14, the diameter is 28, so radius is, and the radii of the two smaller circles will be 7 each. They are touching that, so 7. And total area of two smaller circles will be pi into 7 square r square plus r square 2 into 7 square pi. So this is pi into 7 square, pi into 7 square, we can write it as 2 into 7 square pi. This is the total area of two smaller circles. Area of the larger circle is pi into r square of that. R is 14 of the larger circle, so we can write it as pi into 2 into 7 whole square equal to 4 into 7 square into pi. So just kept an eye on what is possible. And the required area will be 4 into 7 square into pi minus the other one, which is 2 into this, and which we can see this is 49 into 298 pi, which comes to 308, which is the answer. This was calculation intensive. So let us move to the next question. What is the simplified value of tan theta by 2 plus cot theta by 2? This one, this one, this one, this one. One option is that you apply your trigonometric knowledge and do that, but every time that is not required. Just test it at one of the possible values. I choose pi by 2 because it is theta by 2, and it will become pi by 4. Pi by 4, pi by 4. They are 1 each. Tan pi by 4 is 1, cot pi by 4 is 1, so this should be 2. This means I have to find that option which is 2. The only option that gives 2 at theta equal to pi by 2 is 2 cosecant theta, because cosecant pi by 2 is 1, and therefore it will be 1. This will be 0, this will be 1, this will be 1. So this was simpler to substitute, to take a test value and find out the exact value at that point. What is the simplified value of secant 3x minus tan 3x by secant x minus tan x? This is a bit complicated expression. The values are given as very simple. So what we'll do in this case is that we will pick out a test point and we just choose to put x equal to 0. When x is 0, secant 0 is 1, tan 0 is 0. We already know. So this denominator will stay as 1 minus 0. And the other terms will fall, obviously. This will be secant 3 0 minus tan 3 into 0, which is 1, because this is 1, this is 1. So this part becomes 1. Now we have to see what this one is. 2 tan 0, this is 0, goes away. And the last one will also disappear. So what we'll be left with is, we'll be left with 1. And therefore, fourth option is the correct option. So this is how we could have easily solved. I have even explained all the 17 questions in 22 minutes only. So this is how you should take up. Thank you. Closing it right now.